Derek.
Hello, love.
You haven't brought Elizabeth with you, then?
Sorry, Chris. Not until we get a few things straightened out. I mean, it's just not fair on the kid. You know that.
Yeah.
Look, it's not a matter of us trying to keep Libby away from you. You're her mother. It's just, if we come to some sort of arrangement, then you can see her as often as you like.
Chrissie, look, this isn't easy for any of us. I think we should just get the paperwork signed and get it all over with.
What paperwork?
Look, Chris, well, Brenda and I, we can't take it like this anymore. If you're not prepared to do things properly and give us some peace of mind, then we're going to have to take it to the family court.
You've been talking to Mrs. Morris, haven't you?
Oh, come on, you know it's the right thing to do. Susie?
Okay, Mr. Grace.
What happens now?
Well, she's got to come with me, but it's just routine.
Well, what for? I mean, you're not going to charge her, are you?
Look, as I said, her minor offences don't interest me. She helps us, as I expect. There won't be any trouble. Nothing to worry about.
You want to have it off? Don't be pathetic, Mason. Look at you.
Oh, I could be very good
right.
for you.
Right. You are now on another charge. Oh. Attempted bribery of an officer.
Oh, come on, you better.
Now, crawl up your walls or bash your head against them, but forget about any deals with me.
Oh, you bit my
Wanted to see me?
Yes, I've been reading your report on Donna Mason breaking into the drug cabinet.
Yes, well, sister was pretty upset. I gather she's just about had this place.
Oh, she's not the only one. Mason should never have been in the area in the first place.
Well, we can't watch them all the time. I mean, we're just not equipped or staffed to handle these problems.
I know, prison's hardly the place to keep drug addicts. I was talking to Vera Bennett earlier, and she's practically at her wit's end trying to cope with the drug situation in Barnhurst. She hasn't a clue as to who's smuggling it in or organising it.
Yes, well, with Margot Gaffney and Marie Winter as inmates, I'd know where to start looking.
Mm. Well, she's already tried that. If they are involved, they're covering their tracks very well. I see that you've got Mason in solitary. Do you think that's wise?
Well, what else could we do?
All right, but keep a close eye on her.
Yes, of course.
I thought by putting Mason in with Smith, we would have solved our problems.
Well, B has tried. I mean, according to the women, she was up all night with her.
Mm. Well, in that case, she's not going to be very pleased with Mason now.
You've been gone a long time now. I've been worried about you.
Yeah, well, it wasn't exactly my fault.
Bad, eh?
Yeah, it could have been worse.
Much worse.
Yeah.
Well, you two look as though you could use a cuppa. Any takers?
I'll get it. Is there any food?
Yeah, there's some cake in the cake tin, though. You managed to get the information out of her on Des Williams?
Nothing that would help, no.
That poor kid, she's scared stiff.
Yeah, well, I'm sort of responsible for that. I told her I was going to charge her with prostitution, trafficking and possession.
Oh, well, that's great, isn't it? After all that kid's been through, come off it, Inspector. You'll never make that stand up in court.
Yeah, I know, but she doesn't.
Yeah, well, she will.
Just hang on a minute. I also told her that if I didn't bring the case to court within 12 months, the charges may be dropped. In other words, if she plays it straight, keeps out of trouble, she may have nothing more to worry about.
But that's blackmail.
Well, I call it insurance. I mean, it's surely better to scare her a bit than have her back on the game or in the hands of pushers, hmm? Look, I won't stay for coffee. She's got a lot to think about.
Has he gone?
Yes, love.
Is he coming back?
Well, he won't have to if you keep out of trouble, will he?
No.
Move it along, Daniels. They're supposed to be working. They're probably waiting for that trolley in the laundry.
No point in busting a gut, is there, Miss Ferguson? I'm not going to be in here very long, am I?
The idea was that if I made things easy for you, you'd do the same for me. Now, you're not keeping your side of the bargain.
What do you mean?
Like talking back in front of the other women yesterday. I wouldn't bother with that again.
No bother? It was just a joke. I'm not going to be in here for very long. So you've got nothing to worry about.
If anyone should worry...
Ah, Miss Ferguson. I don't think you're in any position to tell. Well, come on. You've got nothing to worry about. The other women reckon we're on together. They don't know I've got anything on you.
You talk, Daniels, and you're finished.
Yeah, well, there's no need to be like that. Can't you take a joke?
Oh. I enjoy a good laugh, Daniels. But you remember Queensland, don't you?
I had nothing to do with that.
Well, if they were to think that we were friends, perhaps the same thing might happen to you.
Miss Ferguson, I don't want any special favours. I'll be out tomorrow. You can forget about me. Okay?
I won't be doing that, Daniels. Now, get back to the laundry.
Yeah. All right.
About bloody time. Where have you been?
Well, there's no point in rushing, is there?
Where have you been?
Nowhere.
Probably been out having an early morning workout with the freak.
Oh, come off it. I wouldn't touch her with a 10-foot pole.
So what would you do for her?
Nothing.
And how come all the little favours?
Yeah, I reckon they're on together, B. We're not.
Either that or you've got something on her. And I think it's about time you shared your little secret.
There's nothing.
You're not going to be able to answer Ferguson back with a broken neck. Just remember.
What's going on, Smith?
Nothing.
It looked to me like you were threatening her. We can't have that, can we? I think you need a change of air, Smith. You can clean out the showers and the latrines. Daniels, get on the press.
I don't want to work on the press.
Oh, don't worry. You won't have to work too hard. We wouldn't want you tiring yourself now, would we?
Yeah, well, I don't mind doing my bit.
Then get on the press. Right, Smith. The latrines are filthy.
Look at that bloody little crawler. Thank God she's not going to be in here for much longer. With her contact, she'll end up running the place in no time.
I don't reckon she's on with Virgo.
No? Then how come she's on the press, eh? She must be paying her off somehow. Maybe she's a lagger.
Well, if she is, nobody's found out about it yet. And she knows all about my grog supply. Screws haven't got on to that.
Yeah, but you're her mate, aren't you? And she's not going to dob you in while she can still get something out of you.
She's not me mate. We just have a few laughs together.
Oh, God, you're weak, Lizzie. One little giggle and you're anybody's.
Well, now that's more like it. A nice, peaceful atmosphere. Any trouble?
Well, I haven't been bashed yet, if that's what you mean. Why'd you put me on the press?
Would you rather be scrubbing the latrines with Smith? You wanted a deal? You can't have it both ways.
You really enjoy having me strung out, don't you?
Just like you tried on me.
B's gonna have to do something.
Yeah. I wouldn't be surprised if that's not what Fergo wants.
Another new one?
Well, not new, unfortunately. Mouse is one of our more regular clients.
Mouse?
Yes, it's a nickname. Her real name is Heather Trapp. This is Officer Ferguson.
Oh, good eye.
Prostitution, petty theft, possession, and illegal use of drugs. Sounds more like a rat than a mouse.
Donna Mason is due out of solitary. Could you take her down to the showers before she goes back to her cells? I'll admit Mouse.
Right. No doubt we'll be seeing plenty more of each other.
This way, Mouse.
Straight there, long as she been here.
Long enough to know the tricks of the trade, Mouse. Put you on cleaning duties, B.
Oh, who do you think?
I did. The break will do her good. She acts as if she owns the place.
Make a difference if I was young and pretty.
Did you say something, Smith?
Just get on with your work, B.
Right, you get cleaned up and then I'll take you to the laundry.
What are you doing here, B?
What does it look like? I have to ask you the same question, though. What is this time, petty theft or prostitution?
You know.
Yes, I know.
What's wrong with her?
Mind your own business.
Drugs?
Well, I want you to know that I tried, I did.
Yeah, that's what your sort always says. I don't know why I bothered.
Please don't, you don't know what it's like.
Oh, yes, I do. I've said it 1,000 times, but no one can help you unless you help yourself. Now, why don't you get in the shower and get cleaned up? You stink.
We've got to go to the loo.
Oh, say hello to B for me while you're there.
I'm down to the loo. Anybody got any messages for B?
Oh, yeah. Will you tell her I'm sorry?
I'm sure she'll be thrilled. Hey, Lizzie. I got something I think you might be interested in.
No, thanks. I've got to get on with me work.
Yeah, but look, it's the real thing.
Figure give you that.
I don't give a damn whether you feel up to it or not. You're on laundry duty, so pull yourself together.
But you can't do this. I feel bloody awful.
Well, then the work can just take your mind off it.
Oh, come on, love. You can give me a hand. It's only a bit of folding. It's not hard. Here. Would you like a nip of this?
Oh, don't waste it on her, Lizzie.
Oh, she's all right, poor kid. She's just a bit spaced out. You know how they get. Hey, 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 hey. Go easy on it.
Oh, no, thanks, Lizzie. You keep it.
Oh, beauty. Did Virgo bring this in for you?
Let's just say I've got me connections.
What connections?
Ask no questions, get told no lies.
Yeah. Well, whatever it is you've got on, Fergo, it's bloody worth it.
Come in.
Oh, so are you going out?
No. I just thought I'd have a shower and clean up a bit.
You feel better?
No.
Come and sit down, love. Susie, you mustn't dwell on this. You ought to try and get it out of your mind. I know at first it's going to seem impossible, but you can do it if you try. And don't forget, honey, I know what I'm talking about. I used to want to have a dozen showers a day, but it's not really your body you want to get clean. It's your mind. That takes time, love.
What am I going to do, Judy?
You're going to have to hang in there. And I'm going to help you all the way, huh? Let's look on the bright side. Inspector Gray said that if you keep out of trouble, he'll probably drop the charges. All we have to do now is concentrate on getting you a job, and you can stay here until you're really settled. You're going to have a brand new life ahead of you. And the first exciting thing on the agenda is lunch. You get changed. I'll meet you downstairs.
I forgot.
I've got one more load to pick up. I won't be long.
G'day. I'm Mouse.
What? Mouse? That's my name.
Oh, yeah? Who's supplying you with the stuff?
What do you mean?
The dope. Where are you getting it from?
Why, have you got some?
No, I just got back here. But I know my way around. I've got my contacts.
Yeah?
It's not the really good stuff, of course, but it's something to get by on. And at the right price.
When can you get it in?
When I get the money.
See you soon.
You're doing. You know I've got a week ticker.
Oh, I didn't, sorry.
Well, I have. That's why I came in here for a quick nap. They overworked me, you know.
Should you be drinking in your state then?
It's medicinal. You keep an eye out for the screws while I have 40 weeks.
It's almost empty. Hey, I've got some friends who can smuggle some in. Do you want to be in it?
Yeah. I always like a drop before I go to sleep.
Of course it'll cost.
Well, you get it and I'll pay for it.
Well, the money has to be up front, you know.
What's the matter? Don't your mates trust you?
No.
Neither do I. So you get the grog and I'll get the dough.
Lizzie, it doesn't work like that. You know, you've got to have the money. They hand over the grog and they otherwise have to make two trips, you know. Lizzie!
The
screws will be wondering where you got to.
Oh, all right, all right. You can't get a minute's peace.
Come on, hurry up or we'll both get into trouble.
Oh, where's Donna?
Donna? I don't know. She's probably in the laundry. Why?
Well, she wasn't here. She reckons that she'd get me some grog if I give her some dough.
You've had enough.
I've only had a drop. Besides, I wouldn't trust her with me money. It's gone.
What is?
Me dough, you bloody fool. It's been knocked off.
Come on.
Got the stuff?
I've organised it, but I told you. Money up first.
How long?
I'll be back in no time.
Right.
Hey, where's Mouse off to?
I don't know.
Well, where's Lizzie's money?
What money?
My money, the money you pinched.
I didn't pinch nothing. You were so drunk, you probably just can't remember what you did with it.
I wasn't full, I was sleepy. Now, where is my money?
I don't have it.
Yeah, well, we don't believe you. Now, you give it back to her.
I can't. I've already arranged to get your grog.
Yeah, well, unarrange it quick or it'll be too late for you.
Oh!
We're waiting.
Here, what's going on?
Oh, Donna here is a bit crooked, Mrs. Sam.
Is that right, Mason? Go to your cell and lie down. If Mason feels sick again whilst you're around, Doreen, you'll go straight to solitary.
What are we gonna do now?
Find Bea. She's the one who's been helping this druggo. She can sort it out.
Was there any trouble when Mason was released from solitary?
Not that I'm aware of. Why?
I thought Smith might have reacted badly.
Now, well, Smith was in the latrines cleaning when Mason had her shower, but there wasn't any trouble.
Good. This is the list of prisoners to be released. Would you inform each of them?
Well, do you think that's wise, letting them know in advance?
Oh, most of them keep their own record. They know almost to the minute when they're to be released. Sometimes they get a little confused with remissions and so on, but it's normal policy.
Mm, we didn't do that in Queensland. It can lead to trouble. Well, it gives the women time to plan little deals and arrange for things to be smuggled in and out.
Well, there's nothing we can do about that. And anyway, as for the letters, they'll be searched before they leave. Besides, you'll see that Doreen Byrne's name is on that list. She's a long-termer. And as she's made quite a number of friends in here, she should be given the chance to say goodbye properly.
Whatever you say.
How are Latham's injuries?
She's perfectly all right. Overreacting is her main problem.
That may be so, but she's to be kept on light duties only until she's fully recovered. Is that clear?
Very well.
Good. That will be all.
What would Donna want with grog? She's only interested in one thing. I wonder who's supplying her.
Well, Donna, she was with Mouse when we caught her.
That's not Mouse, as usual, scene. She'd have been back in here 5 minutes.
Maybe it was Maxine. Oh, I don't reckon Maxie would be into that sort of stunt.
Oh, shut up, Lizzie, and lay off the grog. You know your brain seizes up after you've had a few drinks.
Well, I wasn't full. I was just sleepy.
Yeah. One thing for sure, if Maxine is involved, we know who's helping her bring the stuff in. Let's find Donna.
God.
What have you got there?
I was just taking some pills the nurse gave me.
Was that Nurse Mouse or Nurse Maxine?
What do you mean?
You got your hands on some stuff, didn't you?
No.
You liar! You pinched Lizzie's dough and you bought some dope, didn't you?
I took Lizzie's money to buy some grog, I told you.
And where is it? Where is it?
All right, I took her stupid money because I'm a drug addict and I always will be.
Oh, I said I was going to help you, and by Christ, I will. I'm not going to let you out of my sight. You have just started cold turkey.
Oh, yeah? What are you going to do? Tie me to the bed? Shove a pillow on my mouth when I scream and I can't stand it?
Yes, if necessary.
No, you're not. You let me go.
I'm not letting you out of my sight.
I know what you're trying to do. You're not trying to save me. You're trying to save your stupid bloody daughter, or she's dead. She's dead.
You naughty little bitch! People try and help you! Oh, look what they get for it. Well, you aren't fit to mention Debbie's name. Oh. Now go on, get out. Get out!
Okay.
Go and kill yourself! And the quicker the better!
You look all in, Smith. Cleaning duty's too much for you.
I can take anything you dish out.
Even when you're up half the night holding your junky mate's hand?
I wouldn't have to be if it wasn't for the scum as supplier. You wouldn't know anything about that, I suppose.
Don't tell me you don't know. I thought Queen Bee knew everything. You're losing your grip lately, Smith.
I've got my suspicions.
If you're thinking of me, forget it. Drugs are one thing I draw the line at.
Even if it's in exchange for favours?
Oh, don't be stupid. Junkies can't be trusted inside or out. They'll try anything for a fix. Anything.
She'd have to be desperate.
A bit of advice, Smith. You're helping a loser there. Seen her type before. She's marked. A pine box is all she's got to look forward to.
Well, haven't we all?
Sit down.
Thanks. That's nice.
Yeah, it's for Chrissie's little girl.
Oh. I was just wondering if you could do me a favour, Hannah.
Sure, if I can.
Well, I was expecting some money in today and it hasn't come through, and I need $15 in a real hurry.
Donna, I haven't got $15.
Well, maybe you can lend me some of it. It's always the same when you try and help someone. Lizzie asked me to buy something for her, and I paid the money to somebody else, and now she wants it back, and I don't know what to do.
Well, I've got $5. You could have
that. Give her nothing.
You keep out of this. It's got nothing to do with you. It's between Hannah and me.
I suppose the money you nicked from Lizzie was just between you and her, too.
It wasn't my fault she changed her stupid bloody mind.
She didn't change her mind. You pinched it. And if she thinks she can get away without paying Lizzie back before she disappears outside for her court case, any money you loan her will go on dope, too.
You gonna give it to me or not?
Thank you.
wrong with Mason?
She just didn't like the company, Mrs. Powell.
What's happened to the great campaign, Smith?
You know me, Mrs. Powell. I'm not into bashing my head against a brick wall. I just made a mistake. That's all there is to it.
So you don't think she's worth saving?
I don't think she can be saved.
What's all that about?
Never mind. How'd you call her?
They bought Elizabeth her first little bike today.
I mean, that's a really big deal, isn't it, in a kid's life? And where was her mother? Stuck in bloody jail, that's where.
Well, at least you've got something to look forward to when you get out, eh? Not like her nibs.
Yeah, I suppose so. I want to be there when things like this happen. I just want to get out of here, B.
Yeah. Aren't we all? Oh, by the way, Hannah. You never give money to a junkie. Not ever. Understand?
Oops. I'm sorry about what happened today, B. I said I'm sorry. What else do you want me to say?
I just want you out of here, okay?
You don't understand, please. All right, so I broke into the infirmary, so I took some pills with Lizzie's money. So I let you down. Well, I'm sorry. I've got to go to court tomorrow and I have to be straight. Will you help me?
I'll speak to the screws about having you moved out tomorrow.
I expect you've heard the news that Burns is to be allowed a farewell party.
Yes, I don't really approve.
I couldn't agree more, but I've decided to keep my mouth shut.
You have to. There's not much you can do about it.
No, not a damn thing.
Oh, that reminds me, Mrs. Davidson wants you to tell Burns about her release date today. Oh, doesn't matter. Perhaps I'd better do it.
No, it's all right. I'll do it. Stokes, Burns, Mason, Simpson, Latham, Kennedy and Smith, laundry.
I asked for light duties.
So fold some towels.
At least you're back with us in the laundry.
Yeah, she's probably been scrubbing the floor with a toothbrush. Tell you what, she's missed someone out, though. Excuse me, Miss Ferguson, but do you want us to take Daniels to the laundry with us?
Shut up and mind your business, Smith. Daniels. Garden duty. As per your request.
I didn't ask for garden duty.
Oh, make up your mind, Daniels. Well, now, Burns, what about you? Do you want to work in the garden?
Yeah, all right. I'll do it. Better than working with this lot anyway.
Now, listen here, Max. Don't you go getting yourself in too deep with that bitch Ferguson. She'll bury you alive.
Yeah, but only if I let her, and I'm not about to do that.
Whatever sort of little deal you got going with her, it's getting you offside with the other women, you know.
Yeah. I know. But I got some news for that fat lot of slobs. I got a phone call last night. Me boyfriend's coming in the Savo to pay off the rest of me fine. I'll be out of here today.
Latham! Laundry! Daniels, keep your mouth shut and get out to the garden.
You on strike, Doreen? Oi, seamstress, I'm talking to you.
Oh, sorry, B, I was just trying to work something out.
Thought you were doing a time and motion study.
No, I'm trying to work out how much longer I've got to go.
Now, hang on, you said you had about a week to go.
Yeah, I know, but I think I must have made a mistake because I haven't heard anything.
What about that extra time you told me about over the guard dog business? Have you got that in?
Yeah, but I've got a couple of remissions to cover that.
Well, what about the bloke you nicked off with from the roof?
Oh, yeah, that was a mistake. Got 18 months for that. But 12 months of that was to be served concurrently. So that gave me an extra 5 months.
Oh, bleed, Nell. No wonder this country's going down the drain. 6 months, Dore. 12 from 18 leave six, you great bird.
Oh, bugger it.
Yeah, give me a look at that.
Ha,
Well, congratulations, Doreen. You've boiled it down to two possibilities. Either you were due out last April, or you've got another 27 and a half years to serve. Never mind, we'll ask Davo, but she'll probably give you an extra couple of months for all the time you spend in the loo.
Oh, come on, B, this is bloody serious. I could be serving extra time in here and I don't even know it.
Well, isn't this nice? Everyone's having a wonderful time. What do you find so amusing, Mason?
Nothing.
Well, wipe that stupid grin off your face. Come on, get back to work, the lot of you. Seems to be your problem, Burns.
I'd like to see Mrs. Davidson.
Beg your pardon?
I'd like to see Mrs. Davidson, please, Miss Ferguson.
Well, I don't think she particularly wants to see you, Burns.
Yeah, well, I'd like to see her because I'm due out of here any day now and I'd like to know exactly when it is.
You'll be told at the appropriate time.
I want to know now. I've got to organise my party.
I said you'll be told on the day.
That's not fair. I've got plans to make.
How does an extra couple of days sound to you, Burns, for disobeying an order? Now get rid of that rubbish and get back to work.
Bloody great bitch.
I reckon it's still just got to be a few days until I get released. It's just got to be.
Don't you ever let up, Doreen. Trevor's mad at lunch. It can't be. They would let you know by now. Dave always gives a long term as a bit of notice.
Well, maybe she's forgotten this time.
You don't think she keeps it in her head, do you? It's on file. The department would notify her as well.
Yeah, well, you know what they're like. They've probably lost my file. I could be in here forever, and you know what'll happen then. They'll blame the rotten computers.
OK, Mason, Inspector Grace is here. Come on, you wanted to see him. You're going straight to the court after the interview, too. Wish me luck, will you? Come
on. Now, come on, Mason. You're wasting my bloody time. I need names, I need dates, and I need places.
I've got to get something out of this. If I'm going to nail these people, it's got to be worth my while.
I think you're trying to con me. I don't think you know anything worthwhile. I think you're about as bloody useless as that Susie Driscoll.
She's just a kid. She doesn't even know where it's at, let alone where to put it. Des wouldn't have let her know anything important. I've been around longer. I promise you, I know things and I've seen people.
There you go again. What things? What bloody people?
I've got to get something out of this. You know what I want.
Yes. Yes, I know what you want. But what you get depends on me.
All right. I'll give you a list of names and I'll even tell you where they keep the stuff. What's that worth to you?
All right, I'll tell you what I'll do for you. I'll personally take you to the sister and make sure you get all the medication you need to get you through.
What if she doesn't play ball?
Then I'll bring in a doctor from the outside who will.
I want the real stuff.
Real stuff? You get medication or you get nothing. Now use your bloody head. You know what it's like to come out of this cold turkey?
Yeah. I want $50 too. It's not for me, it's for a friend, okay? Oh,
Jesus. $50. What for, to buy drugs? You've got to be joking. I've gone as far as I'm going to go with you already.
It's a deal.
Good girl. Now, just one other thing. You give me the names, you give me the places, and you're going to have to testify in court. Now, it's no good you giving me all this information if I can't nail the bastards. And, of course, it'll be a lot safer for you, too.
As long as you do what you say. Might as well go out on a high.
Oh, I'm sick of this. Somebody else can do the next load.
Yeah, maybe we could get Maxine in from the garden. She's had a pretty easy day.
Yeah, I'd like to shove her in with a load of sheets.
And her girlfriend.
Ooh, I know what I'd like to be shoving.
Oh, yeah, right. Need a few of you out there to help unload the laundry truck. Smith, Latham and you, Stokes. And what's amusing you, Simpson?
Nothing, Miss Ferguson.
Let's see if you can get a laugh out of cleaning the toilets.
But I didn't do anything wrong.
Oh, G3, Mr. Faulkner's waiting for you at the security gate.
You, come with me.
Where to?
I just told you, the toilet block.
Can't I clean out somewhere else?
Well, you're frightened of getting your nice little hands grubbed. Don't worry, you'll be safe. But life could have been a lot easier for you if you'd been a bit smarter at the start. Now move.
Oh, I've got to lose some weight. Every time there's a heavy job, I get lumbered with it because I look bigger and stronger than everyone else. Hey, a gander at Ferguson's fag. You'd think she was recuperating from an operation.
Okay, Daniels, you can cut the act. Wouldn't want you to exhaust yourself, would we?
Get inside. Pack your things. You're being released.
I'm getting out. Then bloody testing. Excuse me.
Lucky bugger.
Don't worry, she'll be back. Her sort always is. But I give a week's buy-up to find out how she got round Ferguson.
No. Come on, you lot, get a move.
Oh, all right, all right. Well, well. I wonder if she'll live long enough to make it back
Inspector
here.
Inspector Grace. Oh,
that bastard will feed her to the wolves when he's finished with her.
Yeah, I know he's a mongrel, Chrissie. But he's about the only chance she's got at the moment. At least he'll look after her while he thinks she's got something he wants.
Hiya, scrubber.
God, Maxine, almost had a fit.
Why did you think it was? The bear.
I don't know, I just got a fright, that's all. Yeah, who's the bear?
Ferguson. Who else?
We call her the freak.
Yeah, I know. Well, I call her anything I can get me tongue to. The bear, the freak, dickhead.
God, you're a trick, Maxine. You're a bright spot, Renny, you really are.
Yeah, well, not for long, sweetheart, because this little one's about to walk right out the door.
You lucky bugger, how come?
I'm having it off with Davo.
God, doesn't anything worry you?
Nah. Secret to my success. Never let the bastards get you down.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
Yeah. Anyway, see you, love.
Bye.
You've been having a bit of trouble with Fergo lately, haven't you?
Well, why do you think I'm cleaning the toilets?
Well, I do have one other secret to my success.
Yeah?
And it's all to do with keeping Fergo under control. I don't think she'd mind if I shared it with you.
Well, they finally unloaded the laundry van.
Mm.
Not the fastest operation I've ever seen.
Doesn't surprise me.
I hear we're losing Daniels.
Yep, good riddance. I think if she'd been here much longer, she just might have met with a nasty accident.
Was she upsetting some of the women?
Who else?
Well, where's the farewell committee and the brass band?
Where is?
Oh, I thought at least the governor would be here to shake me hand and tell me how much she's going to miss me.
She sends her love and hopes you had a good stay. Sign here.
Well, it hasn't been so bad, yep. As a matter of fact. Quite a surprise meeting up with old friends. Useful, too.
I'm wanted over in C block.
Oh, see ya.
Listen to me, you little slut. Don't you think for one minute that you've got the upper hand on me. It was worth doing business with you because you were only here for a short stint. But believe me, if you ever come back, it'll be a whole new ball game.
Thanks for the tip, Butch. There was... Oh, yeah. I got one for you, too. I dropped our little secret to one of the other girls.
Who?
For her to know, and you to find out.
Right, Simpson, on your feet. I'm putting you on a charge.
What for? What did I do this time?
Well, I've just inspected the shower block that you're supposed to have scrubbed.
Yeah, I did.
It looks like a badly kept brothel.
Then you should feel right at home, shouldn't you?
Oh, little Miss Purity's finally found some guts. Or are you just feeling lucky?
Not lucky. Just prepared. Maxine gave me a little going away present about when she knew you in Queensland.
Oh, so you're the one.
Now, I let Daniels get away with that for a while because she was only in here for a short time. But you, you're a long-termer. You don't imagine that I'm going to put up with that hanging over my head for long, do you? Now, Latham tried to stand up to me, and she's a lot tougher than you are.
I wouldn't do anything like that to me if I was you, because you don't know who I've told.
Right. Well, just exactly what did she tell you?
How you forced yourself on someone, gave her privileges, presents. Only your protection wasn't very effective, was it? The other women got to know and they bashed her up, didn't they? They got a bit carried away and they killed her.
They murdered her.
Yeah, and you went on a little bashing spree of your own, didn't you? Until the authorities found out and forced you to resign. I'm sure there's a lot of people that'd like to know about that now.
Trust Daniels to make something dirty of it. She didn't understand. Nobody did. I was a good officer, straight down the line. And then I met her. I'd never met anyone like her. She was quiet, gentle, and I loved her. And she loved me too. Oh, there was no pressure. There was no need. Then they killed her. I've been looking for someone like that ever since. There's no one. There's nothing left but the scum like the ones who killed her. I thought for a while that perhaps you...
over these figures a dozen times and I still reckon that I'm due out of here any day now.
Yeah, what are you going to do if they do let you out?
I don't know, get a job, I suppose.
Well, the way unemployment is at the moment, you'd be likely to draw your old age pension before that happens.
Well, I'm in no real hurry. I mean, I got some money to see me through for a while. I got quite a bit left over from selling my house, you know.
Well, why don't you go on a holiday first?
Yeah. Maybe I could go to Surfers or even Cairns. Somewhere really swank and sunny.
Like a stunning week at Elwood Beach.
Mason's moving out. Put your things together.
Hi, girls.
Well, you're looking a lot brighter. I suppose we can thank the cops for that.
Yeah, in a way. Gave them the information they wanted.
Yeah, for a price, no doubt.
Yeah. I'm going out on probation. I'm going to live at the halfway house now.
Well, Susie's living at that halfway house. Now, I'm going to get every prisoner who leaves here to check you out. And if you so much as give her a headache powder, I'll break your bloody neck. And what other deal did you make with the cops?
Methadone.
Huh. So that's why you're looking better. Well, it might work. But with you, I doubt it. Because you have to have guts to kick that habit, and you don't want to give it up, do you?
Listen, I started dying the first time I took a hit. I had to get up today and give evidence about everyone in the drug business. How long do you think I'm going to last, even if I do get off it? It'll be realistic.
Yeah, I suppose you just said it yourself, didn't you? You started dying the first time you picked up that needle.
One way or another, it's only a matter of time, isn't it? He knows it, you know it, and I know it. By the way, I tried to make another deal.
Oh, yeah? What was that?
I tried to get Lizzie's 50 bucks back. He wouldn't give it to me, so will you tell her I'm sorry? Bye.
Bloody riddance.
Oh, shut up, Doreen.
Oh, Mrs. Powell.
Yes?
I'd like to see Mrs. Davidson, please.
What about?
I'd like to lay a formal complaint about one of the officers.
Well, which one of us this time?
Officer Ferguson.
Oh, who else? Now, come on, you didn't get very far last time.
This time it's different. This time I've got witnesses. Lots of them.
He used to give me roses
I wish he could again. But that was on the outside, and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines, and the rain falls down. But the sun and rain are prisoners too. Around. Last night I dreamed we were together, sharing all the love we'd known, till I had to face the nightmare, awaken up alone. On the inside the roses grow, they don't mind the stony ground, but the roses right.